I sacrifice all of the days of my life. I'll be here worshiping all of the days of my life. I'll be here worshiping. As the musician begin to play this line, ask the Lord for something. Ask him for something. No one comes here and goes back the same way. It's not possible. I'll be here worshiping all of the days of my life. I'll be here worshiping all of the days of my life. Everybody say, I'll.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, the verse 18, be not drunk with wine wherein in excess, but be ye filled with the Spirit. He makes this comparison intentionally. Before you can get drunk, you can never get drunk by accident. You have to do something intentionally. Not only that, you have to do it repeatedly. It's the same with the Spirit. Lagadama sakia, tigomanda falia kata, talitoma sigabana, rabababashata, rabanosata. Paul said in Philippians chapter 1, the verse 25, I am confident I'll be with you for the furtherance of your faith and joy in believing. Rabashata. Awareness is a crucial point in the Spirit. And as you are here, I want you to be expectant. Be ready for something. Look forward to something. But one thing is for sure, your prayer life is not going to be the same again. Your Bible study life is not going to be the same again. Rabashata, speaking tongues. Rokotokota, command yourself. Mention your name. Iris. Rabashata, I'm on fire for Jesus. I'm on fire for Jesus. I love to pray. I love to study the word. I love to be filled with the Spirit. I love the Holy Ghost. Reketekete. Hikonda bradaga. Rada telebedema. No more mediocrity. No more mediocrity. I'm on fire. Ah! Hey! Oh, palagasete. Arabata. Arabata. Kantalaba. Hey, kalaba. Hey, barosata. Ibodana. Ibodana. Yetele kete kete kete. Butala. Arababashata. Hey. Hey. Rokopona. Ade. Hey, barakapanosa. Mandala bratata. Hey, palababashata. I'm on fire. I'm on fire. Hey, paragosata lamanda. Say this after me. I'm full of the Holy Ghost. I can hear you. I'm full of the Holy Ghost. And I'm full of fire. From the crown of my head to the tip of my toes. I'm full of the Holy Ghost. I love to study the word. I love to read the word. I love the word of God. I love the companionship of the Holy Ghost. Jesus is my best friend. In the name of Jesus. Rabashata. No more mediocrity in my prayer life. I love to worship. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And all that is within me. Praise his holy name. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's another Sunday and another Shofar assembly. I just want to look to your left, to your right. Just tell someone it's good to see you. You can elbow someone. You can say hello. Oh, come on. Be nice. Be nice to each other. Come on. Give someone an elbow. Give someone a hi. Hello. You're welcome. Hello. We just want to welcome those in particular who have come back from school. We say welcome. It's good to have you here. Amen. Amen. We just want to worship this morning. Just want to lift up your voice, lift up your hands, dig deep into your heart. Psalm 19, the verse 1 says, the heavens proclaim the glory of the Lord, and the skies, the firmament proclaim his handiworks. Even by virtue of how we've been made, without a sound, without a voice, our very nature gives glory to the Lord. Hallelujah. The way the universe itself is weaved together by the power of God gives glory to him. The same chapter says, without a voice, without a sound, their message goes out through all the earth. Our very nature gives glory, gives honor, acknowledges his power, acknowledges his beauty. And this morning, we just want to add to that by just giving him worship, by saying he is great, by saying he is mighty, by saying he is awesome. In your own way, just commune with the Lord. Commune with the Lord. He is here. He's in you. Sing to him, speak to him. thank him, acknowledge him. He is God over everything. He is God. The heavens proclaim your glory, Lord. The planets, the galaxies, the beasts of the field, the nebulae, the quasars, the black holes, everything, the plants. Why don't we join them and say, God, you are awesome. God, you are mighty. Hey. Look at how you've made us. Without a sound, creation gives glory to your name. Oh. You want to continue and say, you are mighty. You are glorious. And you are holy. Give him your praise. Give him your worship. Hey. We cast down our crowns. Lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. Oh. We cast down our crowns, yeah. We lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. This is our song. We cast down our crowns, yeah. Lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. Oh, we cast down our crowns, eh. We lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. Every soul, everybody join me. We cast down our crowns. We lay it all down at the feet of no one but Jesus. Oh, everybody sing, we cast down our crowns. We lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. We cast down our crowns. We lay it on down at the feet of Jesus. Only you are worthy. Oh, everybody, cast down your crowns. We join with all the angels. To the Archbishop of Heaven, we cast down our crowns. We lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. We lay it all at no man's feet. But you, we cast down our crowns. We lay it all down at the feet of Jesus. Every voice, we cast down our crowns.
We cast down our crowns.
We lay it all down.
We lay it all down.
Wherever you are, lift up
at
your
the feet
voice.
Of Jesus.
Come pay homage to the King. Hey, we cast down our crowns.
We cast down our crowns.
Like the surrender for our elders.
We lay it all down.
At the feet of Jesus. We can sing this forever. Oh, we cast down our crowns.
We cast down our crowns.
We lay it all down.
We lay it all down.
At the feet of Jesus.
At the feet of Jesus.
Oh, we cast down our crowns.
We cast down our crowns.
We lay it all down.
We lay it all down.
You wanna learn? You wanna learn?
At the feet of Jesus.
The only one that is exalted. We cast down our crowns.
We cast down our crowns.
We lay it all down.
We lay it all down.
exalt him, exalt him. Oh, we cast down our crowns. You are lifted above everything. At the feet of Jesus. Oh, we cast down, we cast down a cross, yes. Lord, we lay it all down. Oh, we are created for you. We are created by you. We cast down a cross. You are my purpose, yeah. At the feet of Jesus. Oh. Express yourself, yeah. Oh, yeah, Lord. And you are holy. You are holy. Words can't quantify, but I say you are holy. You are holy. You are holy. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah. Join with the angels and the 24 elders. Holy, holy, holy. Hey. We join with the angels and the 24 elders. Holy, holy, holy. Everybody, we join, yes. And the 24 elders, we say, holy, holy, holy. Nothing can describe you, yeah.
We join with the angels.
We cry, we cry, we cry. We join with the angels, yes. What makes you happy is our strength. What makes you happy is our hope. Oh, we join with the angels, yes. Everybody join in with all of creation. Come on, add your voice, add your worship, add your praise. Everybody, oh, we join, we join, oh, we join. We join with our dance. Oh, 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 oh. Celebrate the Lord. Oh, we join, we join.
We join with the angels.
And the 24 elders. We find pleasure when we sing. Holy, everybody, holy. Ah, hey, we join,
we join.
And the 24 elders, holy, holy, holy. Come on, church, let them hear you sing. We join with the angels and the 24 elders to sing holy, holy, holy. And we cry, oh, there's nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. Oh, there's nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord.
There's nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Lord. Hey, nobody, nobody. Everybody sing, we say nobody like you, Lord.
Like you,
you're in a class of your own.
Like you,
I have been around and I have seen that, nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you, Lord. I have seen nor heard of anyone with so much love, so much mercy, so much grace and wonder. Nobody like you, Lord. I can barely comprehend.
Nobody,
nobody like you, Lord.
Nobody like you, Lord.
great one, great one, great one, great one. We worship your name. Great one, great one, great one, great one. We worship your name. Everybody say, great one, yeah. Great one. See, awesome in all your ways, yes. We worship your name. Sing great one,
yeah.
We worship that name of Jesus. Above it all, yes, is the name of Jesus. Great one, we worship your name. Oh, great one, great one, great one, great one. We worship your name. Oh, great one, great one, great one, great one. We worship your name. You are worthy.
give a clap unto the Lord.
Hey, Shofar Assembly. Hey, let me hear it echo. Shofar Assembly. Hey, hallelujah. You want to dance and praise?
Yeah. Hallelujah. I want to put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
So we will celebrate our God. We will celebrate our God. Let his banner be raised. Let his glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. Let his banner be
raised. Let his glory be seen. We will celebrate our God.
We will celebrate. We will celebrate our God. Let his banner
be seen.
We will celebrate our God. So we go to hail your name day by day. All the way, we go to him. Come on.
All the way,
we go to hell.
Hail, Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to say you are Alpha.
Worship you,
because you are, say,
you are Alpha
and Omega.
And Omega.
We worship you,
because
you are.
We give you all the glory.
We worship you, because you are.
Hallelujah! Celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible makes us understand that for God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son. This morning we are here to sing of the love of God. Hallelujah. His unconditional love met us even in our lowest moment. Amen. So are you ready to celebrate Jesus this morning? Are you ready to express your love to Jesus this morning? Give the Lord a clap offering. Come on! Woo.
They put the nail through his hands. They put my thorns on his head. But he still wraps me in his arms. He still wraps me in his arms, and I see your grace it abound. Oh, and I once was lost, now I'm found. But you still wrap me in your arms. You still wrap me in your arms. Oh,
come on. Wave your hands to Jesus.
They put the nail through his hands.
They put my thorns
on his head.
But he still wraps
me in his arms.
He still wraps me in his arms.
Come on, raise your voice and sing.
Now see your grace. Jesus, I was lost,
now I'm found.
But you still wrap me in your arms.
Me in his arms.
So you still wrap me.
You still wrap me in your arms.
Come on.
How far you've come for me.
I know the Bible. Why you love me so? Honestly,
how far you come for me.
I know the Bible.
Yes, I know the Bible.
Why you love me so?
So
when I remember how your love has come.
I know the Bible.
Why you love me so?
You love me.
When I remember how your love is ransomed.
There is love where you are. There is peace where you are, Lord, Jesus. There is freedom where you are. There is healing where you are. Sing where you are. Where you are. There is love. Where you are. Sing where you are. Where you are. There is peace.
I know the Bible. Yes, I know the Bible. My mind did not fit comprehend why you love me so. When I remember, I know the Bible. I know the Bible. Morning, your love is unconditional. Hey, we know the Bab, how you love us so much. We know the Bab, how you love us too much. Hey, yeah. I know the Bab.
When I remember
how your love is covered. I know the Bible.
So
when I remember
how your love has lifted.
I know the Bible.
So when I remember
how your love has transformed.
I know the Bible.
When I remember
how your love has ransomed.
I know the Bible.
Say
when I remember
how your love has transformed.
I know the Bible.
Yeah.
When I remember
how your love has ransomed
me.
How your love has ransomed me.
I know the Bible.
Yeah.
I know the
Bible. When I remember.
When I remember.
How your love has covered me. I know the Bible.
When I remember
how love has covered. How your love has covered me.
Know the Bible.
Say when I remember. Your love has ransomed me. Your love has ransomed me. Snatched me from the jaws of the enemy. Say when I remember. Your love has lifted me. And you said I'm seated with Christ in heavenly places, far above demons and principalities. Oh, when I remember how your love has transformed me, how your love has transformed me. Oh, when I remember how your love has covered me. Shouldered me day after day, day after day. How your love has lifted me. Your love has lifted me far above every other thing. Your love has lifted me far above every other name. When I remember, yeah. Come on, celebrate Jesus this morning. Yeah. Oh. When I remember Jesus, when I remember how you love me, when I remember how you saved me. Woo! Hey, I see. How far you've come,
how far you've come
for me,
for me.
I know the path. Yeah, yes, I know the
path.
Why you love me so?
I see.
How far
you've come
for me.
I know the
path.
I know the
path.
I know the path.
Why you love me so?
Oh,
I see
it.
How far you've come.
How far you've come
for me.
I know the
path.
Yes, I know the path.
I know.
Why
you love me so? When I remember,
hey,
how your
love has covered me. I know the Bible.
Oh,
I know the Bible.
When I remember, how your love has lifted me. How your love has lifted
me.
I know the Bible. Come on, celebrate Jesus.
Like getting paid, where the hustle go company. it, say amen. If you believe it, say amen. If you believe it, say amen. 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 Everything you put your hand on, your name go open doors. You serve go be a boss. Amen. Amen. Everything you put your hand on, your name go open doors. You serve go be a boss. Amen. Amen. Sister, where one man sees until where the fight begin. One day you go punch Jesus. Amen. Amen. Then that way don't losing job. Landlord come they do like God. One day you go be landlord. Amen. Amen. Good news go locate you. What you see in a good day. If you believe it, say amen. No. Amen. Amen. Everything you put your hand go up. Your name go open doors. You serve go be a boss. Amen. Amen. Everything you put your hand go up. Your name go open doors. You serve go be a boss. Amen. Amen.
All right, it's okay. All right, everything you put your hands go work. Go give you open door. You self go be a boss. Amen. What you see landlords do, one day you'll be a landlord. I like that one. I like it. It's a young man's song, so play it and be shouting. So when you say, if you believe, we say amen, you shout amen. Amen? It's a good song. We call this spiritual songs. Spiritual songs are songs the Holy Spirit puts on people's heart. You may not find scriptures in them. You may not find them say God, but it is an inspirational song when the Bible talks spiritual songs given by the Holy Ghost. And it inspires people. I like this song a lot. And I'm going to preach to you about the grace, the giving grace. Let me talk it up. The giving grace. Say the giving grace. Say the giving grace. Shout the giving grace. The giving grace. The giving grace is one of the grace God releases to be a blessing to his people. It starts in a very hard way. But when you learn to take that grace, your life will be like this song. You will be a boss. God blesses you. God increases you. Amen? So we'll talk about the giving grace. I've told you in this church many times that grace did not only save us, but grace also helps us in our various individual challenges and callings. That is one of the other aspects of grace many people don't know. We know the saving grace, but that is not all the grace. Grace is just more than saving. The one that saves you also propels you and brings to you another level of grace that you must find, which will help you to be different, to be able to make it, to be able to prosper, to be able to do things according to the assignment of God for you. For example, the grace I have as a teacher and a pastor may not be the same grace Pastor Connie has as a pastor in his life. We can all be teachers, but there are different graces. That's why the Bible talks about gifts of healings. If you take Dr. Ampia Kofi in Ghana as one evangelist that does a lot, you see his level of healing. You see the way he does his things. You take somebody like Bishop Ajin Asare. Simple. He has also got his. You take somebody like Bishop Dag in his mighty miracle crusades. Simple. So what is the difference? They have different graces to live and to fulfill their assignment. So in life, what God has made you to be, he will give you enough grace to help you to be. This is the hope of every child of God. If God says tomorrow you'll be the president, now you would not look it. You may even look like you don't have the mind for it. You may look like you are not intelligent. You may look like you were not made for it. There have been stories about people who, during their school days, teachers wrote them off. And they grew up and found grace. And the grace was able to let them do things. Let me tell you something, which I may have to explain to you people here alone. May not be in my main sermon. Talent and gifts are different. Talent is what you were born naturally with. And you may not be a Christian, but you have a talent. Everybody has a talent. Because of the position of strength you have. Everybody has a talent. Everybody, human being, has a talent. When you are not born again, your talent will not glorify God. You use it for selfish means, so it doesn't glorify God. A gift is given to us by the Holy Ghost at the time of your new birth. So, talent is when you are physically born, biologically born. Gift is when you are spiritually born. But what happens also is that immediately you get born again and you submit your talent to the Holy Ghost, your talent enhances your gift to the glory of God. So your talent comes to support your gift. Then you are able to glorify God. Let me give you an example. Paul was a zealous man. He said, I was zealous in my father's religion. I went about killing everybody. If I heard you were a Christian, I'll kill you. But he said, when the Lord found me and revealed himself to me, then my zeal now is about the house of God. So the same zeal has come into the... That's why Paul did many things. So his talent combined with the spiritual gift God gave him is now working his ways. Let me tell you something about Pastor Yusuf. Most of you don't know. When we're in school and we're not born again, he wanted to be a commentator, football commentator. That was one of his passions. No, you could be passing. You could be passing and you see people gathered. And you'll be hearing commentary. You think it's football. Those days, commentary were only on radio. We had Joe Latte and then Thompson. And it's Harry Thompson. Over to you, Joe Latte. Then Joe Latte will pick it up. Then when he goes out, he'll say, over to you, Harry Thompson. Then Harry Thompson, those guys were so good that even when they retired, I think was it Joe Latte? He was employed in Nigeria. When he retired in Ghana, they took him to Nigeria. He worked there for several years. But what I'm saying is that those days, commentary was only in the radio. So you could see small radio and people are surrounded it. Pastor Yusuf could be in the school, secondary school, and will be giving commentary and people are around him and laughing. And you think they are listening to radio. You only go there and see the man is sitting there. Talent. Now, he gives his life to Christ, submits the same talent to God. So when you see him preaching and talking like that, it's a gift. The talent has been taken over by the Holy Ghost. When you see him doing those things, that is exactly what he used to do. Now, so that is that. But what God gives you to make sure that as a young man, whatever he has called you, the gift he has given you, the calling he has given you, your assignment, your destiny can be fulfilled, is to find enough grace. Grace is what God uses to help you. Say amen. Now, one of the graces God uses to help every believer is the giving grace. Say the giving grace. Come on, shout the giving grace. 2 Corinthians chapter 8. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 1 to 4, and then verse 7. Let me read the New King James first, especially when I'm dealing with this, so that they will understand something. Moreover, brethren, we make known to you the grace of God bestowed on the churches of Macedonia. So there is a grace God gave to the churches in Macedonia, which perhaps other churches didn't have. So the grace we may have here, another church may not have it. The grace you may have, another church may not have it, or another person may not have it. I want you to understand that God has enough grace for everybody. I thought you would say a good amen to that. I thought you put your hands together and say amen to that. May you locate your grace to become who God wants you to become. Listen, you will never be a failure, because God will give you enough grace to make you what you must be. Can I hear you lift your hands and shout amen? Are you here this morning? I shouldn't tell you to shout amen before you shout amen. So, moreover, brethren, we make known to you the grace of God bestowed on the churches of Macedonia, that in a great trial of affliction, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty abounded in the riches of their liberality. Now, this is a long sentence. What he's saying is that they were in a difficult time, the churches of Macedonia. They were in very difficult time. They didn't have enough. But the joy that they had abounded even in a time of poverty to their ability to richly give. So this is somebody who doesn't have. But because they have grace, they have found the grace to give. Even though they don't have, they are able to give. It's like the widow who took all her coin and went and dropped it into the basket, and Jesus said, this woman has given more than anybody. That is, even in the time of their poverty, in the time of their lack, they have some joy in giving. May you have a joy in giving. Listen, and I will tell you why God wants everybody to have that. May you have joy in giving. I said, may you have joy in giving. May you have joy in giving. Otherwise, you won't find some things in life. That's how that grace works. All right, the verse 3 says, for I bear witness that according to their ability, yes, and beyond their ability, they were freely willing. So that grace makes you give even beyond your ability. Somebody say, how can you give beyond your ability? That means your heart is ready to give everything. You are ready to give everything even if you don't have it. You see, there are people there, before they got the money to give you, they have vowed to give. That's beyond their ability. He's walking around the place, saying, this song, one of the portions we didn't get to say, one day you will sign a check. One day, you too, you will sign a check. And when he says you sign a check, it's a check you will sign and know that you have signed a check. One day you will sign a check. That is also in that song. Connie, I like that song. You self will be a boss. You'll be landlord. Everything you put your hands go work. Give you open doors. You self go be a boss. Amen. 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 Say, so you will sign a check. Amen. So there are people who give beyond their ability. That means they are ever ready. The day the thing comes, they have no question. Lord, I want to be a blessing to the church. I want to be a blessing to humanity. His heart is ever ready. The day the thing comes, no, there's no question. He doesn't struggle in giving. That's giving beyond your ability. Imploring us with much urgency that we will receive the gifts and the fellowship of the ministering to the saints. So they are giving us a gift and they are urging us. We are saying, oh, you cry, you don't have, you are a student. They say, take it. I have a joy in giving. When you have a joy in giving, you are setting a platform for your own blessing. Amen. You are setting a platform for your own blessing. Start it now as a child, and you are setting a platform for your own blessing. Amen. Give me verse 7. Now watch what verse 7 says. But as you, Paul is writing to the other church, the Corinthian church, and he says, I want you to know the grace that is upon the churches in Macedonia. Then he said, but as you, the Corinthian church, you abound in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in all diligence, in your love for us. See that you abound in this grace also. In other words, Corinthian church, you abound in faith. You are good in speech. You are good in knowledge. You have a lot of diligence. You love us. We want you to add this grace to. We want you to add the grace of giving, because when you have all this and you don't have the grace of giving, you are lacking something. You see, the grace of giving is not a special grace for some people, because the Bible says, give and it shall be what? It shall be what? It shall be what? It shall be what? Given unto you. Giving is the only means by which God also makes people give to you. So giving is not something that is for some special people. Giving. So Paul said, see to it. Make sure, Corinthian church, that as you abound in all other things, make sure that this grace, you too, you abound in it, because it is the means by which you will be blessed. Can I hear somebody say amen? I pray that you will abound in the grace of giving. Why are we teaching you young people this? Why are we teaching you this? We are teaching you the path to your great financial breakthroughs. That's what we are teaching you. We are giving you the principles by which you can live and become richer than your parents. Oh, you didn't say an amen. Every parent wants his children to be richer than him. It's only a bad father and mother who want their children to suffer. You want your children to be richer than you, so one day they can buy you a private jet. They can build a bigger house and say, Daddy and Mommy, stay here. In your old age, they can take care of you. Can you imagine your father and mother? That's what they are waiting for you. In their old age, you should be able to take care of them and take care of them well. But if you don't have, how will you take care of them? How will you take care of them? So you must have. Tell somebody, I must have. I must be rich. I must prosper. Are you saying it well? No, I'm not saying it like you believe it. Hey, are you here? Am I speaking to young people who have an aim to become something? You are sitting and looking at me as if you have dropped from heaven. Amen. We are teaching you great principles. Sit down. You don't believe it, eh? No, I don't see it in your face. The way you are sitting and looking at me. When I was like you, and me and Connie, when we were like you, if we were getting people to speak to us like this, I don't know. I think Hedy Kintu is in the same shoe. I don't know when you gave your life to Christ, but if we had people to teach us, sit us like this and teach us what we are teaching you, I think by now I would have been far away. Far away. You know, far away. No, I would have been somewhere. But I pray that you will be somewhere. I pray that you'll be somewhere. Giving grace. Start it. When you are in school, give to your fellowship. Don't say because you are a student. We used to take our allowance and go and pay tithe. Apart from tithe, you make sure that you are giving monies to the fellowship. We used to do that. So every one of us must learn to walk in the giving grace. Amen. So Paul said, Corinthian church, you have everything. Gate pastures, Shofar assembly. You are good in everything. I can see you can sing. You can play equipment. You can do everything. You can sing. You are ushers. Look at them everywhere. They are doing, young people, they are doing things. You can do all things. But you know what? It is not enough. All of you, see to it. Make sure that you also abound in the grace of giving. The Bible says it is better to give than to receive. Do you know why I say so? Because the more you give, the more you receive. If you are always waiting to receive, you are not a good student of the Bible. You have 2 pence, share with somebody. Give one to your friend. You will get another one. Amen. Amen. Giving is a grace. When you grow, there is a certain amount of giving. Until you employ the giving grace, you cannot give. And that's why he says they were giving beyond their ability. As you grow in life, giving grace is one of the things you must practice in your life. Receive in abundance and give in abundance. Giving grace opens you for God to bless you. The giving grace. The Bible says something. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, the verse 8. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, the verse 8. And God is able to make all grace, say all grace. Come and shout all grace. Come and shout all grace. God is able to make all grace abound to you. All grace abound towards you. May God make the giving grace abound towards you. All grace means there are grace, different graces for different things. Different graces. The grace to be saved is what saved you. But the grace to minister as a pastor is different from the grace of another thing. So any grace that you need in life, God is able to make it abound towards you. Amen. Why? That you always having all sufficiency in all things may have an abundance for every good work. The reason why God wants to make all grace abound to us is that so that you will always have sufficiency in everything. Money, knowledge, wisdom, understanding, ability to get things done. So you have sufficiency in all things. Why? So that you will abound unto every good work. So that you can do good works. All grace helps you to do good works. The giving grace also helps you to do good things. Amen. One day when you grow up, may you buy buses for this church. Or whichever church you find yourself in. Are you understanding what I'm saying? May you buy buses. There's a young man, like one of you here. He's older than most of you here, though. But he's a very young man. Very young man. When I became born again and I was preaching, he was like this. So he's a very young man. He started this giving grace in some small way. Now he builds churches for communities. He builds churches. He's a young man in Fountain Gate Chapel. He builds churches. He has put up 3 churches so far in communities. One day he was driving, we got here. I said, Pastor, you know we have a church here. I said, yes, we know the church. There used to be a church. He said, oh, this is the one I built for them. I looked at it. I said, stopped. I went and looked at it. I said, wow. Built it. Finished it completely. So I said, you should come and paint it. He hasn't painted it. Like the way this building is being painted. How many of you saw the paint? How many of you were excited when you saw the painting? I'm sure you said, ah, God. Finally, finally. By the end of the week, they will finish the whole front, amen, with the white. And before 31st, they will paint the whole front with the colors before they join to another place. Amen. But giving grace. One of the things I noticed about the giving grace is that it helps you to have all sufficiency. You may start it in a hard way, like the Corinthian, the Macedonian church. That means the giving grace starts when you may not have enough. When you are hard up, but you develop the grace of giving. As you continue, it brings, God gives you all the grace to have all sufficiency in everything so that you can do many good works. Amen. You can go to hospital, you pass through hospital, and then one day, when my daughter gave birth, Phoebe gave birth to in the hospital. No, that was when Kisma gave birth. Kisma gave birth. I went to the hospital to see her. And I got there, and a woman had delivered twins. What to eat? Connie, they said she should bring Pampers for them to put on the twins. She will go out, the people, she will go out and buy two and come and give to the children. And the people said, two? Oh, where is your husband? He's a mason. He's somewhere in the Volta region working. Tell him to come and bring you some money, that he's waiting to collect his money. And the woman was there. Now, it got to a time when she should be discharged. She was still there. And she was lying next to Kisma. I heard the story. When I got there, my sister, my big sister, was taking me, said, oh, pastor, look at this woman. Then my wife and I went close. And I said, what is it? Where's your husband? She said, Macy, he's here, here. He has been here. They are discharging you. Why? You can't go. When they say they need Pampers, that morning he will go out and go and bring two. Life. So we went closer with this. We paid for her. We gave money for the Pampers. We did so many things. And then when we came back out, I noticed she was from Volta region. I came here and I called one of our church members, Mama Dokosi. And I called Mama Dokosi. I said, this is the number of the girl. I want you to call her. Talk to her. Get this. Let's get this. Let's get this for her before she moves out. And then we did everything and she went. Recently, Mama was asking me my sister was telling me that the lady called her to find out how she can get in touch with us. In actual fact, I had forgotten. But I don't know whether Mama Dokosi too forgot. But she called my sister again to see how she can get in touch with us. So I told my sister, is she pregnant again or she's going to deliver again? But those people, you can't stop them from delivering. I'm telling you. But that is the good work. May you have the giving grace to do good works for people. I ever heard of a rich man who went to Kolebu and paid for women who had delivered and they were there and they couldn't, about 30-something. He paid for all of them to be discharged to go home. And he gave the money to all go home. That is what we call good work. May you be that kind of person. But how do you get to that place? Giving grace. Start it now. Don't have quick-pilly-quick hands. You know what they call quick-pilly-quick hands? Say quick-pilly-quick. Quick-pilly-quick. It's a word we coined. It's not from me. Quick-pilly-quick hands is a hard hand. A hard hand. Offering crowd. When you set two packets in one, you feel and you know that one Ghana see this. You know there are some people whose hands can see. When they put it in the bag and they are doing this, they know that one Ghana see this. If they pull 10 Ghana, they say, hey! Hey! We call that one quick-pilly-quick hands. May you not have quick-pilly-quick hands. I said, may you not have quick-pilly-quick hands. Everything you put your hands, you start getting, you self go be a boss. Amen. Amen. May everything you put your hands on work. They are now putting the song there. Put it there, let me see. Everything you put your hands on. Say it. Let me see the other word. Your name go open doors. Ah, you don't like that one? Your name go open doors. You self go be a boss. Amen. Everything you put your hands, your name go open doors. You self go be a boss. That means one day when they hear you, what's your name? Kirsty. One day they say, oh, Sister Kirsty is coming. Then everybody gets up because they know Kirsty. Kirsty is a boss. You see, sit down. One day I saw something. When we were inaugurating our presidency, I don't know whether this time or the other one, President Akufo-Addo, the day they were swearing him in, they laid red carpet. Presidents were passing on it. I saw this man in white walking. I said, which president is that? When I turned, it was Dangote. He too was walking there. I said, where the presidents are walking, Dangote too is walking there. Your name go open doors. Everything you put your hands, your name go open doors. You self go be a boss. Yeah, you will be a boss. You will pay people and take care of them. If you say a bigger amen, it is you I'm talking about. Begin with the grace of giving. Start it as a child. God is able to make all grace abound towards you. What are you waiting for? God can give you the grace. Start it. Like the Macedonian church, they started it in a hard time. When they in their deep poverty, they didn't say. When you notice that you are not willing to give when you are hard up, it means you are not practicing the giving grace. So Paul said, make sure that you too, you have this grace, because it is a grace that will bless you. Am I talking to somebody? Don't sit in church. One day you go sign a check. You self go drive that Benz. You, as I said, you self go drive that Benz. That Benz you saw and you are saying, this Benz is fine. You self go drive that Benz. Dangote go be your friend. When they know you are rich, they will come. You know the rich people, they have a way they talk among themselves. Dangote go be your friend. I mean, these are all rich men in Nigeria. He's mentioning them. We too, who can we mention? Ibrahim Mama go be your friend. No, he's one of the people who has a private jet. No, I think he's one of the people who will just know who he is. Most of the people are hiding. But after Ibrahim Mama, he will be your friend. You will be talking with him on higher levels about business. Oh, these are Nigerian rich people. So I don't get to that place. Me, I want the other ways. I don't even know them. Adenuga, go be your guy. Glow. And that's the glow man, Adenuga. Hey, Nigerians who are powerful men. Why don't we have them in Ghana? You will become one of them in Ghana. You will start your own company and it will go wow. One of the things I've noticed about them, they start, the giving grace, they start it very early. Let me tell you something. The Nigerian company will pay every money he has to pay to be on CNN, to be known. The Ghana man thinks it's too much money to give. So his business is small. Now they have taken over all adverts in CNN when it comes to, what do they call it, something Africa. It is only the adverts. Wild, wild, wild adverts. And they pay to be there. May you have the giving grace. Pay to be anywhere. Pay to do the great things. Am I talking to somebody? Amen. So God is able to make all grace abound towards you. Amen. That grace is what will make you, will help you to be sufficient so that you can support the kingdom, so that you can do good works. Like the Macedonian church, they had that grace. Even when they were poor, they started practicing it. So now Paul is saying, every church, every Christian, make sure that you also have that grace. So giving is not for some people. When you see somebody give something, tell yourself, Me too, when I grow, I go give some and start your way. You see, Jesus is the widow that went and gave man. Jesus is telling us a principle that it is not even how big your offering is, but how costly or how sacrificial it is. Sacrificial. The giving grace makes you to be able to sacrifice. Sacrifice. My last. It may be 10 Ghana, but God sees in heaven as the biggest offering. That is how the giving grace goes. When the Bible says in their deep poverty they gave, how much did they give? People who are poor, how much did they give? But the fact that they want to give, even in their poverty, is what shows that they have a giving grace. Are you hearing me? So when your mom gives you offering, 5 Ghana, don't come and put 2 and keep 3. Some of you children, that's what you do. Mommy says, today we are going to church, collect 5 Ghana offering. Then when you got here, you went and bought chewing gum so that you can get change. When you got the change, you came and put 2 and you left. Hallelujah. How many of you understand it? Good. So it's very important. I'm just about closing. Every church needs the giving grace. And people must have it. The early church had it. Barnabas had a giving grace. He sold his land and gave the money to the church. Every church needs people with a giving grace. That's why Paul is saying the Corinthian church, you must have it. I pray that God will give you a giving grace. Amen. So that one day you will sell. Look, it's nothing when you sell your property to give to church. God will give you more. People don't know that. And Christians, we must know it. We are not wasting it. The giving grace makes you sacrifice so that God can multiply it. So the Macedonian church did this. In Jesus' time, he had people with the giving grace. Peter gave him his boat. Luke chapter 5. Peter gave him his boat. Women ministered unto him their substance. When Jesus needed a donkey, somebody released his donkey. Every ministry needs that. When he needed a place to celebrate his the last Passover, he just sent them, they went, a man prepared the whole place, put all the food, everything there, and said, come and do it here, giving grace. Every ministry needs it. Every nation needs it. When they needed a tomb to bury him, Joseph of Arimathea, he donated a tomb. May you come to the place where you can donate something for church. Oh, you are not saying amen. I'm waiting for a day where people will come to the church and drive a brand new car and come and say, Pastor, we think that this church can take this for ministry. A small bus, we think this church can take this for ministry. We are getting to that place. May that grace of giving come upon you. Because God will give you all the grace to be sufficient in all things so that you can abound unto every good work. Can I hear you shout a big amen? We have a visitor coming to church. I couldn't get him from his hotel. He's now calling. and I was feeling it in my hands. I have a Fitbit, so the Fitbit makes me know that somebody is calling my phone. So I knew he was the one. Before you say, ah, what magic is that? It's a Fitbit. It's a Fitbit. It's not magical. It's a Fitbit. Some of you, this thing, you go home and go and say, hey, pastor has reached on spirit. Even when his phone is ringing, he knows where, no, it's a Fitbit. We have linked the Fitbit to the phone. So when it's ringing, I feel it. I feel the vibration. What is a Fitbit? It measures my rate of exercise and other things. How much steps I've taken, how many miles I've walked in a day. Like all I'm doing is taking it. The calories I'm spending. I'm old, so I'm trying to make sure that I do some exercise. So when I notice I haven't done plenty of exercise, then I go and do exercise. So in a day, I'm supposed to make 15,000 steps. So today I couldn't do much, so I've just started. So I'm doing that. And then I'm supposed to burn some amount of calories. And I'm supposed to do some amount of kilometers, 10,000 kilometers a day by walking around. 10 kilometers. Amen. So you will see that Jesus' ministry needed it. We also need it in this church. And I pray that even as I'm teaching you, may God give you the giving grace. Even as young as you are, may you develop that giving grace. May God bring you to the place where all grace will be sufficient for you so that you can give. Amen. I like one story that I'm going to use to close. Luke chapter 7, the verse 2 to 6. Luke chapter 7, 2 to 6. Luke chapter 7, 2 to 6. A certain centurion servant who was dear to him was sick and ready to die. So when he heard about Jesus, he sent elders of the Jews to him, pleading with him to come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they begged him earnestly, saying that the one for whom he should do this was deserving. For he loves our nation and has built us a synagogue. Then Jesus went with them. And when he was already not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him, saying to him, Lord, do not trouble yourself, for I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Now, this is the story. A centurion is not a Jew. He's a military officer put over them by Rome. You know, they were under Rome. So Rome brought, like the way we were under colonial bondage and British were here taking care of us. That's the centurion. He's an army commander. He's not a Jew. So Jesus came for the Jews. He was preaching to the Jews. But he was working miracles. So this centurion realized that, these Jewish people are good. So he loved them and he built a synagogue for them. He built a church for them. Okay? He went and built a church for them. He built it perhaps before even Jesus was made known. So now Jesus has come. Then the centurion realized that his servant whom he loves is sick and is about to die. So he went to the Jews, the elders, and told them that, look, you guys, can you tell Jesus, I know I'm not a Jew, so that he can come and heal my servant for me, because he's sick. And then the Jews quickly went. The elders went. When they went, Jesus was preaching in a crowd. They got there and said, Jesus, we beg you, ask for this man. He deserves this. He's not a Jew, but he deserves it. Because he loves the Jews so much that he has built a synagogue for us. And the Bible says Jesus left with them to go and heal the guy. So this is a centurion who, through his giving, his sacrifice, Jesus decided to go and honor him. When we learn to walk in the giving grace and sacrifice, God honors us. God blesses us. So one day, whilst you are doing the things you are doing, God will bless you. I said, God will bless you. It's very important that all of us should understand that the giving grace positions you for God to bless you. It positions you for God to take care of you. It positions you for God to make you big. It positions you for God to let you have enough so that you can do good. Stand on your feet and lift up your two hands and pray that, Lord, I need the giving grace. Lift up your two hands, everybody. Lift up your two hands. I said, lift up your two hands, everybody, and pray. That's what I said. Put down your Bible. Put down everything. Put down your phone and lift up your two hands. Lift it up and pray, Lord, I need the giving grace. Pray. Somebody pray. I need the giving grace. I may have grace for everything, but I need this grace. Talk to him. The giving grace. Everything you put your hands, go work. They will play it, but we'll follow it up. Can you people play it? You go and learn before, but they'll play it on the listen. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we lift up our hands unto you. We need the giving grace that will usher us into sacrificial givings for the kingdom, for our nation, and for people. Bring us to the place where this grace, like you said, will abound amongst us and in us. For by that, Lord, you will open us up to our sufficiency, our blessing, our increase, so that your name will be glorified. I pray that the giving grace will abound upon you in the name of Jesus. From today, may God make all grace abound towards you, so that you, having all sufficiency, will abound unto every good work. Receive that grace in the name of Jesus. It starts with you learning to sacrifice. May you have the desire to sacrifice. And may you learn to sacrifice in your givings. Sacrifice for others. Sacrifice for the church. Sacrifice for the kingdom. May sacrifice be part of your life. May you not just be a receiver only, but be a giver also. Can I hear you shout a big amen to that? And put your hands together in Jesus' name. Amen. Do you receive the word this morning? Do you receive the word this morning? All right, I want you to prepare your offering. Take your offering. We are going to sing, "Everything you put your hands, go work." So get up. When they finish, you can. If you package, we can go. Look, do a good offering. Do a good offering. Do a good offering. Don't just do anything. Do a good offering. And those of you who pledged. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Those of you who pledged for the... If you brought your tithe or something, come and put it here. But if you pledged towards the plastering, 300, I'll need a basket here. Put it inside. So if you know you did something, some of you said you would do 100. So if it's the pledge, I need a basket here. If it is towards the painting, put it here. But if it's your tithe, bring that in and put it on. You can't stand. Yeah, bring it. No. Hey, my friend, where did you pick it from? So if it is towards the paint, whatever you pledge, you have brought part or something, come and put it inside this. If it is your tithe, put it here. And then if it's your offering, we are going towards the distance. Come on, let's go. Stand on our feet. Those of you online, please, can you follow? And then the portals are on the screen. You want to also give and give. Learn to give and God will bless you. Come on, let's sing. What's happening?
Go be a boss. Amen. Amen.
All right, sing it, sing
Everything
it.
Everything you put your hand.
It's okay.
Work.
We'll play our thing.
Open doors.
Yourself go be a boss.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Everything you put your hand go up. Your name go open doors. Yourself go be a boss. Amen. Amen. Everything you put your hand go up. Your name go open doors. Yourself go be a boss.
Come on, dance.
Amen. Amen. Long life go follow you. Favor go honor you. Strangers go favor you. Amen. Amen. Long life go follow you. Strangers go favor you. Long life go follow you. Amen. Amen. If you believe it, say amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, say amen.
Amen.
If you believe it, say amen.
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 Everything you put your hand
go up.
Your name go open doors.
Amen.
Yourself go be a boss.
Amen.
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 Everything you put your hand
go up.
Your name go open doors.
Yourself go be a boss. Amen.
Amen. One day you go sign that check, oh. Yourself go drive that Benz, oh. This life go still make sense, oh. Amen. Amen. Your children go make you proud, oh. Bad people no go hold you down, oh. One day you walk the town, oh. Amen. 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 Everything you put your hand,
go walk.
Your name go open doors.
Amen.
Yourself go be a boss.
Amen.
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 Amen. Everything you put your hand,
go walk.
Your name go open doors.
Amen.
Yourself go be a boss.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
One day you go sign that check.
Oh. Amen.
Yourself go drive that Benz.
Oh. Amen.
This life go still make sense. Oh.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Your children go make you proud. Oh. Bad people no go run you down. Oh. Yourself go run this town. Oh. Amen. 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 Everything you put your hand
go walk.
Go open doors.
Amen.
Yourself go be a boss.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Everything you put your hand go.
Come on, put your hands together. I didn't know Anna knew the song small. I didn't know he knew it small. And your man is, what's the name? We are waiting for him and he's not playing. So we are sang. He's good. Amen. Amen. But how many of you believe that you will make it in life? Amen. Lift up your right hand and say, I will make it in life.
I will, make it in
life. I will prosper. I will be rich. I will do good works. God will supply every grace, including the giving grace for me to excel. I receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. Every day when you get up, say that about yourself. Don't look at the conditions. Amen. Don't look at the conditions. Just keep saying it and it shall work for you. Shall we be seated? God bless you. Now, the few things I want you to take note is that you can look here and see. I wanted us to have a youth something on the 27th, but I think let's give that day to the children. We'll find a day for ours. The reason being that because of the wind and the other things that are coming, the children have to use here. I'm talking about the Sunday school children. They will set up this whole place. So we can't combine the two. The second reason is that the thing has become too expensive because of the things they need to bring. So some of you young ones can come with them. Some of those of you who are 13 and that, you can come and play some table tennis around and things like that. Then we give it to the children so that we can be. Some of you can bring your younger ones and also be around. We'll need some of you to help them, show them what to do and all that, so you can come. But we'll have to find time for the youth where you have your games and other things. That's one of the reasons why I've decided that we won't fix chairs. We'll leave it like this so that when we need the space, we'll come and move the chairs and put things and play badminton, things like that. And we can set this, that's why it's big. We can set it anywhere and have some time. So we'll find time for you. So that is the first announcement. I know it's not pleasant to you, but it's pleasant to some of the young ones. You can come with them. Some of the young ones, like you can come with them. So on the 27th, we need all the children here at 9 a.m. They will start arriving by 8:30. The teachers will be there. They'll be here. We'll set the whole place for them, and then they'll come and be here up to about 2. Then their parents will come back and pick them to home. So that is that. But 24th, 25th, 26th, we are having service. What I want, I don't know whether it is too late for you, but your choreography team hasn't shown me that they are still alive. Are they alive? Are you people alive? Is the choreography team alive? So can you perform on the 25th in the morning? Can you perform? I leave that for you. If you can, let me know. So the choreography team can do that. And then on the 25th, you guys will minister, and then the senior quartet will minister. So I want your set. So you wear your shofar things. If you don't have a uniform, wear your shofar things and come and minister. All the instrumentalists, I want you people to minister. And then the other ones will minister. All right. And then we are going to have this. And so the 25th is in the morning. I want to see all your ushers too around and things like that. Let's talk about that. 25th is going to be this. So we are having, 24th is on a Friday. We are having it at 6 p.m. So all of us must be here. Everybody must be here. Don't say it's 6 p.m. It's Christmas Eve. You must be here. Christmas Eve, you must be here. Christmas Eve, you must be here so that we celebrate Christmas together. And don't mind the pushback, the darkness. Pushback, the darkness is now a program. But you see the theme, Holy Ghost explosion. We want to explode here in the Holy Ghost power. Amen. So you want to make sure you come. And then 25th is 8 a.m. Because we have to close for people to go and do their chicken and fish and drink their Fanta. Some of you young people, you take Fanta. We like Fanta. But I will see. Perhaps I may give the young people some Fanta on that day. But we'll see what to do. And then on the Sunday, we will have our shofar assembly. And in the shofar assembly, it is 7 o'clock. You are going to minister. You are going to do that same thing. And then we'll move on. So you get it. All right. So that is all that we are going to have. Then remember the special event on the foundation night. And I'm going to think about what we'll do in the foundation night, whether there's something I'll let the youth do on the foundation night. But I'm looking at it. If your choreography team is working well, I will let them do something on the foundation night before I preach. But we'll put things together. You're not part of the church services, so we'll make sure that everything is done well. Yesterday, how many of you were here for the training? Workers' training. A very powerful moment. If you didn't come, you missed it. Most of you don't have the books because you didn't come. Those who came, they got it free. All right? But learn to come for workers' training because it will help you. God bless you so much. What else do I have to do? Nothing. Can we have the next person coming to come and close us quickly?
Your applause is not loud enough. Daddy, God bless you. Can we say God bless you to Daddy? Wow, they're giving grace. Amen. They're giving grace. Amen. Quick announcements. Those who are 18 and above and have not taken your vaccination, the COVID shots, the COVID vaccinations, we have medical experts here at the Radical Teens Auditorium here to vaccinate. So if you are 18 and above and you have your ID card, please go there and get vaccinated. Amen. The church has made this arrangement, so please take advantage of it and partake. Amen. Number two, as Daddy has announced, we have to follow all these programs. Amen. Finally, as Shofar Assembly and as Desert Parish, it would be good that every Sunday, as part of actioning the giving grace, we will always have a second offering to support the building project. It could be one city, it could be two cities, but commit that we want to do something as youth to support the church building. Amen. Amen. So let's commit to this as well. Everybody has something to give. You can give your time to work in the house of God. You can do so many things. So just find something to do in the house of God. Amen. Let's put our hands together and let's rise on our feet. And we are finishing the Bible reading for 2021 on 31st of December. Amen. Amen. But we are not ending there. It's going to be an annual part of our lives going forward. Amen. So we are starting again on January 1st. So those who want to join Club 300, Club 200, and Club 100, please, not even those who want, we encourage everyone to be a part of this one. Amen. Give your names to Brother Andy Filson or Pastor Michael Arno and get registered. And let's encourage ourselves into reading the Bible end to end. Amen. All right, shall we take our declaration? In 2021, go. May the blessings of the Lord that gives the giving grace and that makes us all sufficient in every aspect of our lives be poured abundantly upon us this week. This week, may the heart of the giver be activated in us and may we find opportunities and channels to be a blessing to family members, to be a blessing to neighbors, to be a blessing to the body of Christ, to be a blessing to the church as a whole. Go and walk in the giving grace and abound in it. In Jesus' name, amen.